The British government is deeply complicit in every aspect of the suffering of the Bahraini people, including Hassan Mushaima. Since the protest began in 2011, the UK has provided the Bahraini dictatorship with over £83 million worth of weapons with which to crush the people. Furthermore, it has provided training. After repeated denials by the UK government, it was finally revealed that having gained experience of repressing protests in Northern Ireland, the British government has used that experience to train the Bahraini security forces in the tactics of ruthlessly crushing protests, use of attack dogs, cannons, and how to gather intelligence on protesters. To hide the training, the UK government has cynically described it as protection of human rights training. Documents reveal that the British government has provided 863 days of training to Bahraini prison guards and officials, including training 400 guards at Bahrain's infamous Jau prison, where Hassan Mushaima was tortured. That training in the UK was paid for by the British taxpayer. Another prisoner who was tortured at the British-trained Jau prison was teenager Ali Al-Sigasi. He was abducted by the Bahraini police and severely tortured with electric shocks and raped. The torture continues for 2 months at Jau prison. He was forced to make a false confession for which he was executed by firing squad in January 2017.
يرزقون